Lily has a very rare condition called linear nevus sebaceous syndrome. It's something that occurs within the first 6 weeks of gestation, and basically it is a syndrome that affects the skin and the central nervous system and the eyes.
Lily, look, wanna play ball?
Yeah. One of the characteristics of sebaceous nevi is that when children get older, they become irritated, sometimes painful, the color changes, and there is the risk, you know, that those can turn into malignant skin lesions.
It's so big that you can't just remove it in a simple surgery. You need a series of surgeries that help generate normal new skin and then use that new skin to remove the birthmark a portion at a time. For her, the surgical process involves what are called tissue expanders, which are like water balloons. And once we put those in, they slowly are inflated every week for a period of about 3 months. And once they become nice and big and they've stretched that normal skin nearby, we can use that normal skin to remove the birthmark. Now the question is, how do we use that skin to remove as much of the birthmark as we can? And so I reached out to my colleagues here at Cincinnati Children's, who were just beginning to explore what can be done with 3D models, to figure out how can I simulate Lily's surgery.
So what I was able to do is produce a 3D model that is exactly the same size and shape of the patient. Once I have that model, I create a synthetic skin that overlays the model.
So this is a silicone rubber that looks somewhat lifelike. If you've ever purchased a Halloween mask, it's most likely made out of the same material. So then you do multiple layers, cover the whole model, and then you get nice and smooth skin.
And then we work to figure out the perfect type of system that simulates what normal skin behaves like. How much stretch does it have? How thick is it? How does it move? And so what we decided to do is to make incisions to remove the birthmark from the center of the forehead and be able to move that normal skin over from each direction. The next step is we're able to make a template. So we make this template now, and when I go in to do Lily's surgery, I'll take this template and put it on her scalp, and I'll be able to mark exactly where the incisions are.
Love you.
Love you, doll.
Okay, we'll take great care of
her. See you. Take care.
Mom and Dad, you'll go with
me. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
All right, we're ready.
So much of what we do in surgery, you can't do it two ways on the same patient. And so I think that being able to model each individual patient's surgery in advance is going to just bring us a tremendous step forward. Her surgery took 4 hours and went exactly as planned. As soon as she was asleep, we put the new template and model on her scalp, and it fit perfectly, so we were able to execute the surgery exactly as we had planned and rehearsed.
She's doing really well. Not quite back up on her feet, but she's getting there. It usually takes a full 24 hours before she gets back to Lily, but she's doing really well.